Hello mga kababayan, welcome to my channel, welcome to laruan ni Obi-Wan. So we have another figure to review from the Ursa Major Wave, so check out your local Targets and Walmarts for availability of this figure. The figure that we have right now is the Stealth Iron Man Armor. These are the items that you expect to have out of packaging for your Stealth Iron Man figure. Basically, you should have the figure in good condition. Second, a Tony Stark head, two orange repulsor blasts, and repulsor handset, and the leg of Ursa Major. If you already had a Tony Stark AI action figure from the previous wave, then you will be familiar with this figure because actually it is just a repaint of that awesome figure and also of the 80th anniversary Iron Man figure. So as you could see, there's a semblance or similarity to them. The difference is just the paint and the difference in heads that are included. Of course, this comes with the AI head, this comes with the full Tony Stark head, a different color of repulsor blasts. But basically, the figure is the same. The Ursa Major Wave is a really awesome wave. So, if you see those figures on pegs, just complete the set, because you won't be disappointed with the figures that are included in that wave. You really have awesome Iron Man armors that are included in that wave, an impressive build-a-figure piece, and the additional characters on the wave will not disappoint you. So especially with this Iron Man figure, even though it is a repaint of this figure from the other wave, I still would like to have this figure because on the previous wave, my favorite action figure in that wave was this Iron Man figure. Since this figure is a repaint of that figure, the first thing that you should do when you take this figure out of packaging, it is not an option to apply heat to the joints of the figure because the heavy paint details on this figure, which makes it really good looking, will really make the joints stiff, or you will have paint that has stuck to the joints of this figure. So heating it up is not an option. It is the first thing that you should do to make this a poseable figure, because this figure that I purchased out of packaging, the joints were really stiff all over. So I had just to take 15 minutes of the video recording of this review just to make the joints work properly. The other thing to take note when you take this figure out of packaging and you have loosened up the joints is to look at the boot area, because sometimes this boot is assembled differently. The leg would be this way and the foot would be arranged at a different angle. So it would be this way sometimes because I had to arrange the boot on this action figure. So I had to correct it to the right position, which is this way. So when I took this figure out of packaging, this leg, the right leg, was arranged this way in packaging, so different from the left boot. So I had to do this, and rotate the leg in order to achieve the correct position for the boot. So those are the two things to take note or to do when you take this awesome figure out of packaging. And look at that. So mirror images of each other, just a different variant or version. So we have the Stealth Iron, the Stealth Iron Man figure, and our regular comic book Iron Man figure. So I won't be tackling all the articulation points on these two figures, because if you already have this one and the 80th anniversary Iron Man figure, then this is no different. So let's enjoy the photos and the video shots of this Stealth Iron Man figure.